What's good, y'all? This is Noah from the internet back again with a short video. This is top five cartoons I'm slowly getting into. I'll explain this for a minute. I stopped watching cartoons for a minute and I kind of gave up at some point. I think maybe 2008, 2007, 2009. But growing up, watching some of these modern cartoons, I realized that they're either really awesome or really okay. You know, they're not as bad as I was making them out to be. And this is my top five list of cartoons that I think aren't as bad as what other people are thinking, or just aren't as bad as my opinion on them before. So here we go. Top five cartoons that I'm slowly getting into. Number five, Clarence. Now, I already explained this cartoon in my top 10 recent cartoons from Cartoon Network. So you should definitely go watch that video if you want to know more about Clarence. I really do think Clarence isn't... I wanted to hate Clarence as well, because this, it was coming out the same time Uncle Grandpa was coming out and Secret Mountain Fort Awesome, if anyone remembers that show. But trust me, it's a really... It's a good show to watch if you're, you know, if there's nothing else on. Number four, Bob's Burgers. When this show first came out and I looked at the visual style, I was like, okay, this is another Simpsons ripoff. It's probably gonna have the same comedy or whatever. So I didn't really pay attention to it. But getting into a few episodes, I laughed. I laughed a lot. This show is very, very Simpsons-ish. Like, it has Simpsons moments. It has this, not really Family Guy, but it has a sitcom. It's a pretty much an animated sitcom, which I'm not really a fan of, but this show does it well. You can tell that there's so much care and heart into each episode and character and detail and design. I think behind the scenes they explained that it takes about a year or two with each episode, and it really does show. These characters are down to earth. They have heart. You can tell that it's a family, and you can tell that it's a family show, which is really good. And it's funny. So if you haven't checked the show out yet, you definitely should. Number three, King of the Hill. Listen, I know the show is old. In fact, it ended. But growing up, I wasn't a fan of animated sitcoms, like I said, and this was slipped right under my radar for me because I really visually just looked like something that I really wouldn't watch as a kid. But growing up, this show is very down to earth, and this show is very subtle in its comedy. The characters are cool. Not cool, but the characters are a family, like I said as well. That all well written. You can tell that Bobby is a kid. You can tell that Hank is, you know, cares, but he's still kind of, I don't know. Listen, this show is a great show. It's a funny show. It's a sitcom, basically. And I really have nothing bad necessarily to say about it. The episodes that I've watched, I've laughed. And I feel like I would only laugh at these jokes if I was an adult. So I'm kind of glad that I didn't watch it as a kid, because I wouldn't got it. And I probably would have said that it is a bad show to this day. But I'm glad that I got a chance to take a peek at it now, because it is a really great show. Number two, Loud House. This is a recent Nicktoon that just came out. I want to say this year, actually. And it's good. Like, visually, it looks like a comic book. So, you know, that's a plus. Who doesn't like that? It's a good show to look at visually. Comedy-wise, it has its hit and miss moments, really. But when you have characters like these, it kind of distracts away from if the jokes are bad or good, because the characters are cool and fun to watch do whatever they're doing. And this show did the first thing that a cartoon hasn't done, which is, I think, is really cool. And it gave a character, I think it was Lincoln's best friend, it gave him two male parents. And the cool thing about it is, like, Lincoln knows, and I think everyone knows, so they don't really, like, what? You won't have two male parents? You know, they don't really address it. They just kind of, okay, whatever, it's cool. They slip it on the radar, which I think is awesome. What an awesome step to take, especially now in 2016. that had to have taken some balls. And I'm glad that it had the balls to do that. Loud House is a great show to watch visually. It's a great show to watch with your kids if you have any. Another thing to notice is that the parents are there, but they're not there. Just, you know, like most good cartoons like Ed and Eddie or maybe Cow and Chicken or the Peanuts shows. They're kind of there, but they're not there because they don't want that to be the focus. They want the kids to be the focus, which is awesome. Always an awesome step in the right direction for me. So yes, Loud House. Number one, Alvin and the Chipmunks. Now, listen. I wanted to hate this show as well. The Chipmunks don't even look like chipmunks anymore. They just look like kids with tails. It's very awkward looking. Dave is very awkward looking. Design wise for the characters, yeah, I understand why you might not watch it, but as I got into it, I think about two episodes in, it's really not bad. Like, the visual choices are about the worst things wrong with the show. Alvin isn't even that narcissistic anymore. He's got some heart. You know, everyone's got some heart in this show. So, is it a good show to watch visually? No. Is it a good show to watch morally, like maybe with your kids or whatever? I'd say so, because the chipmunks are still the chipmunks, you know, and they're still singing, they're still doing their things. The chipettes are there, and they're doing their thing, making music and whatnot. So, is it right to say that it's a bad show? I don't think so. I think you should definitely check it out first and get your own opinion about it. I don't think any of these shows are bad. Clarence is at least mediocre, but I don't think any of the shows I just listed are bad. They definitely all have my Noah from the internet stamp of approval of good cartoons. I definitely think you should check it out if you haven't already. And if you have, let me know in the comments. Let me know what your opinions are on about all of these shows. Do you like these shows? Do you hate these shows? Let me know in the comments. Don't forget to like the video because it helps me a lot. And don't forget to subscribe if you haven't already. I really think you should subscribe. Like, it's one click. Listen, I'm lazy too, but it's just one click. You can't click once. Come on, man. I'm Noah from the internet. Thank you guys so much for watching. I'll talk to y'all later.